What's up, everyone? I'm Nick Mardi for AfterBuzz TV's mini spotlight on, and we have Gavin Houston from Tyler Perry's The Haves and Have Not. So stay tuned.
You're tuning into the destination for TV superfan discussion, AfterBuzz TV. And now, let the buzz begin.
Thank you so much for tuning in, and thank you, Gavin, for being here today.
Thank you for having me.
Well, it's amazing, and first off, we have to talk about season 7 of The Haves and Have Nots. It's a huge show, huge following, so how is it to be a part of the whole family?
It's great. I mean, I'm working with Tyler Perry and Oprah Winfrey, and I think that's a dream come true just in itself. And now, I mean, we use the same crew. We've been in our 7th season, so now it just feels like just going to meet up with family and play. So it's great. It's a blessing, and the fans love the show.
With a huge following, what has been one of the craziest fan experiences?
One of the craziest fan experiences, you know where there are a lot of fans actually, is at the airport. There's times that I've missed flights and literally they've run on and pushed me through security and everything to get me on a flight. I was so thankful. So thank you to everybody working at TSA. I will not be late again.
It was worth the pictures with the fans though.
It was, totally was.
Meeting new fans, I'm sure.
No, it's always a blessing. It always catches me off guard too.
Yeah.
There was one time, okay, so this is a great story. I was walking out of a supermarket and a cop pulled up and swerved his car and threw it in park. He's like, I know who you are. And I got up, I was like, what's going on? He's like, can I take a picture with you for my wife? And I was like, absolutely. So he came out, we took pictures, and it was just hysterical because I was totally caught off guard. I was like, I have groceries.
And inside your head, you're also like, I'm not gonna say no.
Yeah, I know who you are. I was like, okay. Do you need something in my groceries? Caught me off guard. I thought I was being punked.
Really?
Yeah.
I guess that would be a normal setup that would happen. Then you'd probably be arrested. Then you'd be like, the Ashton Kutcher comes out,
you know, laughing.
Yeah. We gotcha.
That would be bad. And he definitely would have got me. That would have been a good one. Yeah.
So let me hear about your character in the show a little bit.
So one of the biggest things with the character is that I play a gay character, which is disapproved by the woman who plays my mom. But approved by the guy who plays my dad. So that's been a big friction within the family. And so this character was rebellious at certain times. He got involved in a murder situation with someone else. And it's just, what's been great about this character has just been a journey of a coming of age, so to speak. And because at first he was closeted and he didn't want to come out to his family, to his mom and his dad. And then finally he came out, and then it was just like mom versus Jeffrey, who's the character. And he's just come into more of his own, and there's been a lot of, and she's done nothing but try to make it as difficult as possible, framing him, having him arrested, having this happen, that happen. He's been at gunpoint. It's been a lifelong journey for the character and for me as well, playing the character.
Yeah. So has Jeffrey been one of the most challenging characters you'd say you had to play ever, you know, emotionally?
I think so, just because the character is so different from me, almost in every way. Just also how he handles being put under pressure and just not being able to, mainly with this character, one of the biggest bullies on the show is his mom. So I guess like any, and I've had to just not judge the character because for me, it would have been a commercial. I would have put her in a place and moved on from the situation.
Yeah.
But he was just so afraid of, Jeffrey, just to give a little bit of backstory, comes from kind of a well-to-do family that's just supposed to be like this cookie cutter, perfect family. And I think coming into himself and being who he truly feels he is, he was scared to tell that to his family, to his mother and his father, just for fear of not being accepted. And I think siding with the character, feeling the empathy, just being able to ground everything in the reality of the situation, which is so different from how I would have handled things, was a challenge. Plus, being a straight male, playing a gay male was a new challenge for me, just as an actor, which I was grateful to have the opportunity to do.
Yeah, well, I think that would be a challenge, playing something completely, you know, literally opposite of yourself, but diving into the character is, you know, something that you could tap into and really play into a T.
And as an actor, you realize you also have, I mean, so many fans have come up to me and saying, like, this is my life, oh my gosh, this character, that's the same situation I had with my family, my parents, or something like that. So you also, as an actor, realize the responsibility you have to take care of this role and this character and to do it right. And it's been such a blessing just to be the one to tell that story.
Have you had a lot of creative freedom with how to display the character, or has any of the EPs or producers told you how they envision him and how they really want you to play him?
No, they've let me kind of have a lot of freedom to be able to just kind of add the muscles to the skeleton. They had a skeleton that they formed. You know, there's a scene that Tyler's written and he has an idea of where it is, and he steers me in certain directions as all the other actors, because I think he comes in with a vision of how this goes, but he's being an actor himself, he knows to let us find ourselves within this framework that he's laid out. And he collaborates with us, we work on it, we discuss it. And so it's really, it's like a boot camp. It's like a big master's class, you know? So I'm grateful for it because I know there's certain things he's needed more, there's certain things he's allowed me to bring into it. So it's been a great collaborative process, and I'm grateful for the opportunity.
And how has it been, you know, living and breathing in the world of Tyler Perry? I'm sure y'all shoot in Atlanta, correct?
Yeah, we shoot.
Yeah, you have to.
You know, and we shoot fast. But you know, I think they always say most of the work that's done by the director happens in the casting mm-hmm. the right people. And I think he expects a lot of us because he knows we can deliver. And it's been a surprise for me just to the amount that I've had to do and the things that I've been called upon to do. But he believes in us, and I think he just knows how to pull that performance out of you, even when you thought, maybe I don't have this, or maybe I'm going about it the wrong way. And it's been a great journey, so.
Would you say this is your favorite Tyler Perry production that you've even watched, you know? Maybe, because, you know, he's done so much work.
I laugh at those Medeas.
Is there something that you would say, no, that's actually my favorite, I would love to be a part of that also? Or are you saying, you know, I'm part of the best thing that, you know, one of my favorites?
I have to feel like I feel like I'm part of one of my favorites. I love everything else, but I'm so just into this now with and knowing the rest of the cast and being that close and actually having the opportunity to work one-on-one with him, it couldn't be a better situation. So this has just been a great platform for me as an actor as well. And I feel like I was placed in the right place, and I'm grateful for it.
Where do we pick up your character from this new season? What kind of situation is going on for us who have yet to catch up now?
He's becoming more rebellious, and he's about to get even with his mom.
Oh, that's one that's sentence and really good.
Yeah.
It was just a comma. There's not even a period right
nope.
there. And what are the projects are we working on right now?
Well, I just did an episode of Grey's Anatomy, which was directed by Jesse Williams, and was a great opportunity. And now I'm open to the next thing that we're kind of in the works with, something that I can't talk about just yet, but
yeah.
Big things are coming.
Well, I feel like you even downplayed Grey's Anatomy.
Grey's Anatomy,
that's another family on its own.
So it's great. I mean, working with Tyler Perry, now being in Shondaland, it's just been a blessing, and there's more to come.
Yeah, how was it like being part of, you know, the Grey's Anatomy family, saying you were a part of that legacy as well?
Yeah.
It seems like you're just jumping into all these shows that, you know, they're not pilots.
You know, it's funny. I have a funny story about that. I was working on General Hospital, and Grey's Anatomy shoots on the same lot as General Hospital. And I remember I was reporting to work, and I saw an actor at the time, Isaiah Washington, who was on the show at the time. It was in the beginning, maybe the first or second season of the show, and I saw them driving. He was in a golf cart driving to set, and I just looked. I was like, "Wow, how lucky is that? What a great show!" And one of these days, I would love to be in that golf cart getting driven to set on that show. sure enough, years later, it happened. So, it's the same thing. Just going in there, it was just, it felt like I'd been there before. It was just, everybody was so welcoming, so professional, and just easy to work with. It's amazing, and it made it clear why that show was so successful.
Yeah.
Because it's just surrounded with good people.
Now, what coast do you like shooting on more? Because you've definitely shot at both LA and Atlanta at this point. Or elsewhere. Is there another place that you could say?
I love shooting in Vancouver. Probably my favorite is Puerto Rico.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Puerto Rico.
Yeah. So I was like, that's not a hard one. Yeah, you know, when in doubt, just go to the beach and everything. No, but it's, I love traveling, mm-hmm. and I love, because I feel like being plucked out of my surroundings, my setting, just drops me into what's going on with the character, and it's easy to focus. I'm so scattered when I'm here at home that I'll be doing one thing and then I'll go off to something else. So it's good for my focus, but I think Puerto Rico was my favorite. It was just beautiful, and I'm a huge water and beach person, so the water, the people, the culture, the food, I just loved it.
Yeah. Well, has that also been the most exotic place you probably shot at?
It definitely is.
Puerto Rico. I can only imagine shooting it there.
It was amazing.
What project was that at the time?
That was, it was called Presumed Dead. Twice I've gone there. One was called Presumed Dead in Paradise. That was a film for a Lifetime. And the other time was The Rum Diary. My first time was The Rum Diary with Johnny Depp.
Yeah, with Johnny Depp.
So I get to do scenes opposite Johnny Depp, and I think just that whole experience, it's called Oso Blanco, a well-known prison at the time. So I think that whole thing, I was like, wow, this is amazing. I love Puerto Rico. Johnny Depp. I did a scene with Johnny Depp, and Giovanni Ribisi, as I was walking out of my scenes, giving me a compliment on the scene.
Yeah.
I was like, this is awesome. I love Puerto Rico.
Well, now, when you say this is awesome and you're in the film, you know, atmosphere of production, what has been your moment where you're like, I'm making it happen in this industry? Was it a casting call? Was it you getting cast for something, getting that phone call?
I think, especially as an actor, you're always having to make it happen. I feel like these victories, these wins, I'm thankful and I'm grateful for it.
Yeah.
But I still feel like there's so much more that I envision myself doing and more to come. And I feel like with every opportunity, it's just like the door kind of cracks a little further open. So you have to do more work to fully kick it open, you know? And I feel like getting more is required, and it puts you in a different playing field where you just have to be on your game. And I think like an athlete always, where you're only as good as you train, and every day there's something you can do. So it's just like being in the gym, the muscle. You can never be overtrained doing this.
Yeah.
You're just getting better and better and better and better. So my goal is to be doing feature films. I love action, or a TV show that requires a lot of action. So that's what I'm training for right now.
When you say action, are we talking more, you know, Rush Hour?
Similar to
TV
Rush Hour,
film,
yeah. I've started training in Krav Maga, and I go to shooting ranges to be comfortable with tactical stuff. So that just action, or even a superhero, I definitely see myself doing something like that in the future.
Now I'm thinking of all the ideas. I mean,
oh, yeah.
What's one film that you could say, that's something I would want to shoot tomorrow? I want to be in that tomorrow. Is there an action film that comes to mind? Or a feature or TV show?
Like Blade 5.
Blade would be the one.
There's also, and a lot of people don't know this, there's a Green Lantern. Ryan Reynolds did the first Green Lantern. The next Green Lantern after Hal Jordan is a character by the name of John Stewart, who's a black character, and who Hal Jordan passes the torch to. And so I would love to do that Green Lantern.
So Marvel.
Different, but yeah, Marvel.
Is
that would
top
be,
of the list.
Yeah, that would be like an end-all goal.
Well, you already created the Grey's Anatomy. You manifested that on the lot.
Right, right.
So that's it.
I'm just gonna manifest. I'm putting this out there.
Yeah, you just put it out there once again.
Out.
So this is not gonna be a surprise when you
first.
Do get that.
You heard it here first.
That's perfect. And now, where can we find you on social media?
I'm at Gavin Houston on Twitter, and I am Gavin Houston on Instagram.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
I'm Nick Mardi. This is AfterBuzz TV's mini spotlight. Thank you guys so much for watching. Catch you later.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Keven Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.